Hi, everybody. Good afternoon. We are now in the afternoon hour as the tropical storm Henri continues to make his passage through the state. And we've got that tropical storm warning in effect for the entire state through this evening. So this is a force to be reckoned with as very heavy rains continue to pour down in parts of southeast Connecticut, now into Middlesex County. We're dealing with some of that very heavy rain. Flash flood warning in effect. I think this is in effect until 12:45. Is that right, Melissa?
Yep.
Okay, 12:45 for southeast Connecticut and the Housatonic River at the Stevenson Dam. A little bit below flood stage, but that is expected to rise as we move through the day today. Look at Groton. Very impressive. 2.5, if not a little bit more, inches of rain there with a 53-mile-an-hour wind gust. That will certainly blow your car around. So you want to make sure you stay off the roads over the course. And we've gotten, let me just back up and talk about one and a quarter inches of rain in Norwich, Old Saybrook, 1.25, and a little bit more than a half an inch in Meriden. You can see those gusts, even Meriden close to a 40-mile-an-hour wind gust at this hour. So as you can see from our regional radar, we've got that moderate to heavy rain continuing to pelt the state. Middlesex County and parts of New London County, you guys are in the thick of it right now. We can zoom on in here and show you where the worst of it is right now. Most of Middlesex County, Mudus, Haddam, East Haddam, these rainfall amounts anywhere from 1 to 2 inches an hour, as Mark indicated with our radar earlier. East Hampton, Durham, Middlefield, you guys are in the influence getting this very heavy rain. And we'll take you up a little bit further to the north in Hebron, Marlborough, Colchester, Lebanon, Columbia, dealing with very, very heavy bands of rain coming down at this time. And it continues to pivot from southeast to northwest. So Torrington, you guys were getting a little bit of a lull about 45 minutes to an hour ago. But as you can see, the bands of moderate rain are just starting to push in towards your region of the state as well. You might be getting a little bit of a lull in parts of northwest and southwest Connecticut, but don't worry, as this arcs over into you, you're going to be dealing with bands of heavy rain as we move through the afternoon and into this evening. So there's the track. Melissa's here. She's going to talk a little bit more about the track and how it's moving through basically right through central Connecticut.
Yeah, that's right, Scott. Now the winds 60 miles an hour. Now when Scott and Mark first came in, the winds were at what? 75 miles per hour.
Yeah.
Category 1 storm, but over the course of the morning, we saw the winds dying down a little bit, went from hurricane status to tropical storm status. And we believe that the storm is making, if not made, landfall right along the Connecticut, Rhode Island border towards between about Westerly and Charlestown. We're still waiting for an official notice from the National Hurricane Center, but as what we've been observing, that seems to be the current case. And we're going to watch Henri kind of cross through portions of Connecticut and then kind of meander off to our west for a little bit before pivoting back east throughout the day tomorrow. So kind of a long duration storm, although the heaviest rain will be today. That's why we have that flood watch in effect. And we're going to keep the flood watch continues through tomorrow, and we will continue to see some rain bands off and on tomorrow. But today is really the bulk of what we're seeing out of this storm system. 3 to 6 inches of rain still looking likely across a good chunk of the state. Locally higher amounts possible if we see some of these heavy rain bands kind of setting up over the same area over and over again. All right. So here you can see on our satellite radar picture, you can watch that center of circulation kind of coming right over land here, right along the Connecticut, Rhode Island border. And we are seeing that very heavy rain continuing to move on into from eastern Connecticut, now moving through central Connecticut. So all along the 91 corridor, get ready to see some of that rain really pounding on down as we go through the afternoon. We're keeping an eye on things in terms of the high tide cycles. We've already been through one, and then the second one comes in later on tonight, closer towards between about 10 and midnight. So keeping an eye on things for storm surge 3 to 5 feet above normal. I've been looking at some pictures on Twitter, seeing some of the rain, some of the water, I should say, from the beaches come onto the roadway. So certainly some flooding a concern along our coastal areas. And I've got reporters all along the shoreline that are going to be talking a little bit more about that. All right, so you can see here as we go through time this afternoon, that axis of heavy rain is right over central Connecticut around 3 p.m. We'll start to see the rain winding down in eastern Connecticut at that point. And as we go through 6 o'clock tonight, still raining heavily in western Connecticut. But after that, a lot of the heaviest rain moves into New York and western Massachusetts. We'll get a little bit of a break overnight, off and on showers and downpours certainly possible. And then as we go through the day tomorrow, as the storm kind of pivots back off to the east, we're still going to be dealing with clouds and off and on tropical downpours, which will continue to add to those rainfall totals. And that's why we do think some areas could see 6, if not more, inches of rain, again, where some of these heavy bands set on up. Mark?
All right, We'll take you through a future cast with regard to winds right now. You can see here as we step you through the afternoon, the strongest winds will be along the path that the eye takes in Connecticut from southeast to northwest. So we could be talking about at times some wind gusts up to, if not over, 60 miles an hour. You can see the latest run of this model of future cast indicating, you can see in coastal southeast Connecticut how the eye is making its way through, eventually up toward the greater Hartford area. So as the storm, though, moves over land, it will be weakening. So the wind eventually will start to decrease as well. So later on tonight, certainly still breezy, but the worst will be certainly behind us by the time we get past sunset. So again, we're going to be dealing with the tropical downpours this afternoon. With tropical systems as well, there's a threat for, as they move over land, and a quick, you know, spin-up tornado, isolated nature, weak and short-lived. The greatest threat for that will be to the east of the storm track, so something we'll keep an eye on as we head through the course of the afternoon. So our eye cams across the state, you can see from Windsor Locks, greatly reduced visibility with the heavy rain coming down there, 71. The rain coming down almost sideways from Torrington. Our camera in store shaking around pretty violently as we take a look at part of the UConn campus there in Gamble Pavilion. Wet roads, of course, all across the state. View from Middletown looking, you know, over toward the Connecticut River. Tough to even make out the Arrigoni Bridge connecting into Portland, given the heavy nature of the rain. And temperatures right now, basically in the low and mid 70s across Connecticut. The air is saturated. We've got dew points up near 70. Of course, it's a tropical air mass. We've got this tropical system that has having a great impact on us. And tomorrow, with enough breaks in the clouds, we could see some rays of sun. However, an ongoing chance, as Melissa alluded to the ongoing, you know, hit and miss kind of tropical downpour, maybe an isolated thunderstorm. Then we are forecasting what will likely be our fourth heat wave of the year. So fortunately, with the way the storm is unfolding, the magnitude of the power outage is probably not what could have been given the shift in track. So if you are one who unfortunately is without power, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, it's going to be a rough go of it with highs in the lower 90s. Heat index values even higher given the high humidity and morning low temperatures, 65 to 70. A cold front moves through late Thursday into Friday. That could generate some rain and thunderstorms, but also brings in some cooler weather behind that for Friday and into the upcoming weekend.